Folks, we're going to show you why coaches go gray. There's nothing worse than having a goal call back. Koharski says no goal, and Quebec players go nuts. Is he speaking French or English? Because Koharski can hardly understand English, let alone French. Here we have a goal not counting against the Habs. What's happening? Does it count or does it? Nobody knows. Still nobody knows. Ron Hogarth skating backward goes over. He's going to confer with his linesman, which should really confuse him. Jean Perron, what's happening? Who's playing here today? What's going on? Get away. That's what they say to you. Get away. I don't know if it counts or not, but by the way Keenan's acting, it's going against Philly, which it did. Would you believe another goal not counting against Montreal? And Jock says he's going to break Klima's neck if it doesn't count. What? Get him by that neck. With that helmet, I would too. Goal judge says no. Jock says yes. Turn the light on. Among other things. Now here's Terry Criss, who thinks Pittsburgh have too many men on the ice, and I don't want you people reading lips. He's either telling the referee too many men on the ice or wants to meet him for dinner at 6. He gets excited like this for Pittsburgh. Imagine what he gets like for Edmonton. Remember now, what I said, no reading lips. Brophy doesn't like this call. John's either got to go to the bathroom or he's doing the chicken dance. Now watch slamming this door. Way to go, John. Watch slamming this door now. I got my finger caught once, and it smarts. Rumor has it that Coach Bob Murdoch locked himself in the dressing room when things were going tough. But the GMs always have a way to make you come out. No use hiding on him. I'm just kidding. The door was really just stuck. But, you know, he doesn't look too anxious to get out there, though, does he? I don't blame him. Every once in a while, coaches even get mad at each other. Here's my buddy Jacques Demers and Herbie Brooks having a little disagreement. Watch poor Tim Higgins getting a work over. Oh, try to hold Jacques back. He's really mad. Look at him go. Whoa, hold me back. Herbie's just bugging Jacques. Thinks he's just kidding. He's saying, come on, Jacques. Come on, Jacques. Jacques. Jacques's not kidding, though. Jacques is not kidding. He's really ticked. Even I used to get upset a little. Great suit, eh? Medill threw me out, and Jerry Cheevers, the backup goalie, coached his first game. I'm often asked, what's the greatest goal you ever saw scored? Well, it was in the Boston Gardens. It was Bobby Orr. Who else? Now, Bobby, when he was killing a penalty, he'd go behind the net, come out in front, go behind the net, come out in front. He'd make monkeys of everybody. So the Flames were playing him, and they didn't want to run in, so, you know, and he'd go around behind the net. So what happens? He comes along the side. They don't want to run at him because, hey, you know what'll happen? He'll go and hide again. Down the side, he goes in the corner, comes out in front and scored. The greatest goal I ever saw scored, and you're going to see it. It's the first one coming up. Let's watch. Okay, folks, watch this one. Bobby's got the puck, and he's killing a penalty. He goes back behind the net and starts back up. Nobody wants to rush him, so he blows by two guys, goes around the defense, sucks the goalie into the corner, and sifts her home. He puts his head down because he feels bad. He embarrassed the Flames. What a guy. Now, Dennis Savard can be the most exciting player in the game. Just watch some of these goals. Watch him weave a little magic against the Habs. Danny Gallivan calls this a spinorama. He loves to score. Now, this one has to rank up there with one of the best. Around Anderson, around Tikkanen, gives Lowell the old how's she going and slides her past Grant. Folks, that deserves another look. Look at him go. Little waterfall. He looks fast in slow motion. A beauty. Now here's Troy Murray, one of my favorites. This has to be a great goal or brutal defense. Walks around Salming, turns Iafredi inside out, and tucks her home. Beauty! Al MacInnis has the hardest shot in hockey. Watch some of these blasters. Billy Smith still hasn't seen it. Lucky it didn't hit you, Billy. In Calgary, they have to reinforce the nets for this guy. He can smoke them. Vancouver's Greg Adams gets a nice one here against Buffalo. Greg Dipsy doodles around Riki and slides it past Pupa. Here it is again in slow motion. Over, back, nice one to the left. Digs their hole. Beauty. Now, what's great goals without one from the great one? Watch Wayne cruise around the net and pop it home. Not much Vernon could do with two guys sitting on him. Now, this has to be the greatest goal never scored. Even though he didn't score, we got to show this. Watch. Around and around. Back. He goes back again. Around, he cuts out. Put it up high, put it up high. I'm telling Gretzky how to score. And last but not least, Mario the Magnificent. Watch him split the two defensemen and pop it in the top corner. Let's see that one in its slow motion. This guy can score with two guys sitting on him. Long reach, that's how he can do it. Before we go to my favorite part of the show, let's see a few funny things that happen in hockey. Now, folks, this isn't really funny. Some jerk in L.A. threw a live chicken on the ice. Finally, after the play stops, the players see it's okay. They hate that stuff. Looks like a new Swedish draft pick. Or chicken a la King. Get it? Nobody calls L.A. chicken now with Miller and Baumgartner. This gives a new meaning to chicken in a bucket. There's Kenny Linsman on a breakaway. Here's Calgary's trainer, Bob Camp Murray. See if he's got any hair left. Watch Steve Finn. Who does he think he's playing for? The Blue Jays? 2 minutes for being stupid, Stevie. Now, there's one thing about my buddy Chris Nyland. He never gets upset about getting a penalty. He always takes it graciously. Now, here he's applauding the ref's call. No, he don't throw it down. He just wanted to give somebody else a drink. Now, don't read lips, Al. Isn't he a wonderful boy? Boston Gordy Kluzak's having a tough time putting the sweater on. And here's my buddy Chris Nyland saying, you put the right arm in first, Gordy. Check those knuckles, folks. That's not from playing the piano. And here's Jerry O'Reilly saying, Chris, let him figure out how to put his own sweater on. This is how they show them to their seats in the Boston Garden. And here's Kevin McClellan and Greg Smith having a little disagreement. One thing about hockey players, they're always gracious to one another. In fact, after the tussle, Kevin even offered Greg his own water bottle. And Greg says, no, thank you, you can have it back. Among other things. And the ref said, if you guys can't play nice, you can't play at all, and sent them home. Don't sweet lips.